Alice Freiling, in her book, Seeking God Together, says that increasing my bank of information is not the same as deepening my relationship with God. Informational reading seeks to master the text. We seek to grasp it, to get our minds around it, to bring it under our control. Informational reading, however, the point is to allow the text to master us. In the next few moments, I invite you to enter into a time of formational reading. Invite God to transform you as you enter imaginatively into the story of Jesus' encounter with Mary and Martha. As you hear the story the first time, I invite you to put yourself in Martha's shoes. How is Martha feeling? What is going on in Martha's mind? In her body? Can you relate with Martha? Think about a time in the last week where you felt the things that you imagine Martha is feeling. As Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to a village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. She had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet, listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. She came to him and asked, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me." "Martha, Martha," the Lord answered, "you are worried and upset about many things, but few things are needed, or indeed, only one. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from her." Martha is described as distracted, worried, and upset about many things. Take a moment to reflect back over this last week. Have you been distracted, worried, and upset about many things? If so, take a moment to bring those things to mind and to lay them before the Lord. Perhaps you connect with Martha, pride yourself in being productive, multitasking, being efficient. Maybe this story bumps you. Take a moment to share those feelings with the Lord. Thank you. Is there anything that God wants you to see about yourself as you reflect on Martha? Anything that God is inviting you to? As you hear the story a second time, I invite you to put yourself in Mary's shoes. Imagine what Mary must be feeling. What's going on inside her body as she sits at Jesus' feet? Do you connect with Mary? As Jesus and his disciples were on their way, he came to a village where a woman named Martha opened her home to him. She had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he said. But Martha was distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. She came to him and asked, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me." "Martha, Martha," the Lord answered, "you are worried and upset about many things, but few things are needed, or indeed, only one. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from her." Jesus tells Martha that only one thing is needed and that Mary has chosen what is best. What is the one thing? As you reflect on the picture of Mary sitting at Jesus' feet, gazing up at him, do you sense an invitation from the Lord for you? The reality is that each one of us are both Mary and Martha, prone to distraction, yet invited to sit at our Lord's feet. What is it that God is inviting you to today? Take a moment now to talk with the Lord about the things that this passage has brought up for you. Amen.